Cow Could Kill You. That headline grabs your attention, right? Well, it's the title of an op-ed on CNN.com, and it got us talking this morning, too. Here's the bottom line. Bacteria, the germs that cause infections, are getting used to super powerful antibiotics, and they're becoming resistant, growing stronger. So now doctors and scientists are warning that minor infections and illnesses could become deadly. Here's how it all happens. Strong antibiotics are placed in feed for animals, all in an effort to keep them plump and healthy. Those animals are then used for food, or their waste gets used on fertilizer on vegetable farms. Then in the form of meats, poultry, or veggies, one way or another, those antibiotics make it to your dinner table and inside your body. And scientists say that those never-before-seen super-powerful antibiotics are actually causing bacteria to grow stronger and immune to treatment. Joining me now from Rochester, New York, Congresswoman Louise Slaughter. She wrote the op-ed that we're actually talking about here. So, Representative Slaughter, you're not only a member of Congress, but a microbiologist as well. So forget the politics of all of this for just a second, okay? And tell me...
Oh, I can do that easily.
I know you can. So here we go.
Politics is pretty awful.
Go into microbiologist mode now and tell me how am I, my family, not protected enough by these FDA guidelines?
Because there is an absolute crisis that almost nobody knows about, and it's tragic. We've been trying now, this is about the eighth year that we've been trying to pass this bill. We can't even get a hearing on it much. Congress, they don't care much either. But scientists who know tell us that within 10 years or maybe less, that a scratch or a strep throat could become fatal. The overuse of antibiotics by the medical profession is part of it, but most of it is 80% of the antibiotics produced in the New York and the United States are used every day in the feed of animals. Now, not because they're sick, but as you pointed out, so that they'll be worth more at the market. The harm that that's causing is almost incalculable, but let me give you an example of what that could mean. Every time that anybody has a joint replacement, open heart surgery, dialysis, organ transplant, any kind of surgery, dental work, you get antibiotics to cut down the infections. What if they didn't work anymore? What if all that science could not be used anymore? Now, over 2 million people a year get sick from the fact that these animals are causing the bacteria, rather, are still on that meat and are resistant to the antibiotics that we feed. The latest outbreak that we had, over 500 people went to the hospital. A larger percentage than normal died. Many of them had sepsis, blood poisoning. And the people who produced the chickens that were at risk here claimed that they didn't cook it. They blamed the victims on it, not themselves and the way they processed the chickens. But what happened is Costco did take some of that chicken and cooked it more than the recommended 160 degrees to 180 and still had to throw out 40,000 pounds because it was resistant to bacteria.
Let me ask you about the political side, okay? The political side of this, right?
Okay.
I mean, this has been a concern since the 70s, right? I mean,
1977.
Okay.
The FDA itself said it's a problem. Yes.
It found that feeding antibiotics to food animals at low doses, both to promote growth and to prevent disease, contributed to a public health crisis. So here's my question. It's almost 40 years later, then why wasn't anything done?
Because I have 400 outside groups supporting this piece of legislation that I've been touting there for 3 or 4 sessions of Congress, 7 or 8 years. And they all are saying the same thing. Scientists all over the country are saying, we have watched Europe do away with the use of antibiotics in cattle feed, and they're doing extremely well with it. But the lobbying against this bill, 12% of about $190 million spent in lobbying against this bill comes from the growers and the producers. And the new guidelines that the FDA put out, the people who produce the animal antibiotics, which are often the same as we use for people, they've said that would not affect their bottom line at all. They're absolutely right. The FDA guidelines have no teeth. They're asking them in 3 years, would they kindly please stop using antibiotics as a daily feed? But there's no penalty if they don't, and really no way to check, no metric to see if they
do. That's because they're voluntary. Voluntary guidelines, right?
Yes.
And the FDA says, the FDA says that's the fastest, most efficient way to make these changes. And I'm assuming you definitely disagree with that.
Totally, I disagree with that. And so does all the medical profession. Most of them have all signed on to our bill and helping to support us. But if we can't get the public aroused, and if they need to be, I'd like them to look on the Washington Post, some article they put in about 6 or 8 months ago on how chickens are inspected, and then ask themselves, is that what they want for dinner tonight?
Point well made, Representative Louise Slaughter. Appreciate your passion, and thank you so much for being with me today.
It is a crisis, and thank you for your attention to it. Thank you very much.
You bet. Mm-hmm.